Next, the resultant force. Suppose consider a body. If there are force one F1 is acting on the body and another force F2 is acting on the body. The resultant force, in the sense, this F1 and F2 are replaced by a single force which is said to be FR. This FR is said to be the resultant force. Resultant force, in the same sense, whatever the effect produced by these two forces on this body, these two forces are replaced by a single force with the same effect produced by these bodies, then they are said to be the resultant force. Nothing but a resultant force is a single force which produces the effect produced by the whatever the forces acting on a body is called a resultant force. It is generally denoted by the letter R. R is said to be the resultant force. Here the role of the resultant force, whatever the number of forces acting on the body, all are replaced by a single force and all the effects are produced by this single force. This single force is said to be the resultant force. This is the first one. And the second one is equilibrium force. Equilibrium force. Equilibrium force is also nothing but a single force which is keep the body, or a force which keep the body at rest or in equilibrium. Suppose consider this body. This body is in motion due to the force applied on its F1 bar. This body is in the motion. To keep the body at rest or to keep the body in equilibrium or in static condition, I should apply another force F2, where F1 equal to F2. That means F1 minus F2 equal to 0. Sum of the forces equal to 0 in the x direction, then they are said to be equilibrium force. In this body, this is the resultant force. Suppose the forces acting on the body are F1 and F2. The resultant force is FR, which is produced by the effect of these two forces and has the magnitude of both these two forces. This single force, to make this body in equilibrium, I should apply the force which is opposite to this resultant force. That is, this is the equilibrium force. This force is said to be equilibrium. It means we can clearly say that resultant forces and equilibrium forces are opposite to each other. That means resultant force is equal to equilibrium force but in opposite direction to the equilibrium force. We can clearly say that resultant force and equilibrium forces are opposite to each other. To make the body in equilibrium, if there is a resultant force, then definitely the body will be in motion. To keep the body in static condition, we have to apply the force. That force is said to be equilibrium force, nothing but in a direction opposite to the resultant force. That is said to be the equilibrium force. Equilibrium force and resultant forces both are opposite in direction. Here we can see that these both forces are opposite in direction and equal in magnitude, that are equal in magnitude and are collinear. This force system, this both force system, it means the resultant force system and the equilibrium force system is said to be collinear forces, because equilibrium force and resultant forces are opposite to each other, equal in magnitude, opposite in direction, and they are moving along the same line.